Second question, one more question if that's okay. Are you still using RSS feed directory submissions and other RSS tactics that have been mentioned before? Tactics seem to come and go so quick, it's hard to know if something that was done 8+ months ago is still valid and worth the time and money to implement today. Yeah, actually, believe it or not, I still think RSS feeds are one of the most underutilized things in SEO. There's a lot of things you can do with RSS feeds that are really powerful. I mean, you know, we obviously syndication networks, they're RSS feed driven the way that we've always set up the triggers that way. But there's still a lot of other things that you can do. Now, I don't spend a shit ton of time on that stuff anymore. But if you're in a competitive niche where every little push helps or you need every little push, then absolutely RSS stuff is still valid. And the easiest way to do it, guys, is just collect your money site RSS feed or your Web2 feeds or all of them if you want. You can combine them together with the feed splicer and then submit that one super feed to just go to Fiverr and search for RSS feed submits, and you can get a Fiverr gig that will do the work for you, that will submit to like 70 directories and aggregators for you, and they'll send you tips. A lot of times they'll send you back a report, and it'll cost you $5 or $10 or something like that. So what, it's easy. It'll only take you a few seconds and let them do the work for you. Okay, but yeah, it still works, guys, there's no doubt. And it's funny because I think RSS stuff isn't, you know, it's an old technology. And so a lot of people don't think that it's still valuable, but it certainly is. There's no doubt it is. Okay. Good question. Good to have you back, Kevin. All right. Let's see. He says, hi. First, thanks for answering a question. This SEO shit keeps me never run out of questions. Isn't that the truth? The more you get into it, the more questions come. That's correct. About IFTTT networks, is building only one ring, that is the money channel brand ring, enough for sticking the videos on SERP? Well, it can be. I mean, you know, there's a lot of variables there. Typically for video stuff though, guys, I don't even start syndication networks for videos and for YouTube channels, unless I'm going to use at least one full two-tier ring, right? So you're going to have a branded ring or a tier one ring. It doesn't have to be branded, but I recommend that you do. So a branded tier one ring, and then you have three tier two rings, which is the full two-tier networks. That's if I'm going to start a new channel and a syndication network broadcast. I call it a broadcast network for videos, but a broadcast network for a new YouTube channel or a new project, I always start with at least one full two-tier network. And that's just, I guess, because I have the resources to do that, guys. If you have the resources, I recommend you do that as well. And typically, I end up with usually anywhere between 2 to 5 full two-tier networks stacked on one YouTube channel if I'm serious about that particular project or campaign, right? So it depends. Like, if you can get results, and the only reason I say that, guys, is because I have, like, you know, I don't do so much of it anymore, but for a period of, for many years there, actually, I did a lot of video broadcasting work for local video production companies. And so I had developed out several kind of like themed syndication networks I had themed YouTube channels. Like, one was for Virginia businesses, one was specifically for contractors. I had one for like health and wellness stuff, and they're just big syndication networks that I created for YouTube. The idea is with blog syndication, I always recommend, and I've been recommending this for years, to just stick with a branded syndication network and don't go multi tiers, because it can create issues and it kind of creates a little bit of a maintenance nightmare, right? It's a pain in the ass to maintain. But for videos, there's no footprint issues. Like, at least it's still to this day, guys, there's no footprint issues with broad, as long as you're using the applets the way that we teach, or you buy the syndication networks from us, with the applets already built, then they're going to work fine. I've never had any issues with YouTube videos getting slapped or sandboxed or anything going through syndication networks, but blog content can, if you're doing multi-tiers. So just to bring it back to what you're asking, I would recommend, you can certainly try it with just one, but if you're not getting the results that you want, then start stacking tier two networks on to the tier one network, or you can also stack additional tier one networks, persona based networks. That's perfectly fine as well. Okay. That's a good question though.